Oh, yeah, man, we're here. We're live, unscheduled live stream, and I got a new pedal coming tomorrow. It's Eventide, and I gotta turn this fan off. Hang on. Excuse me. Still getting used to this setup here, but so I just decided to go ahead and use my Eventide micro pitch pedal to try to make it nice and wide, you know. And this mic is picking up everything. Sorry. So what I'm going to do is let you hear it without the pedal, with the pedal disengaged, right? So this is without the micro pitch, and this is without any delay. Pretty bland. If I unhook the micro pitch and just go back into the delay, it's better. But anyways, let's go back to hooking these pedals up, and you can hear a difference. So you can hear a big difference. I'm right here beside the AC vent, so that's probably what you hear. I'm sorry. I can't do nothing about it. But Bumbleus and S. McMillan, what's going on? Micah's himself. All right. Yeah, this is unscheduled. And so we're going to do a couple of songs. Like I said, I have a new pedal coming tomorrow. It's from Eventide. It's called the Pitchfork. And it's supposed to have all kind of different harmonizers and nice wide sound effects. I just plugged this up just for the heck of it to see if I could get close in the ballpark, you know. So, and it sounds like I can, you know. Yes, Bumbleus, that's right. Like a stereo widener, that's correct. Yeah, that's exactly right. So let's play a couple of songs here. Get my MP3 going and let you hear what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
So you can kind of see what I'm talking about. This is the first time I've used the micro pitch in this kind of setup. So it's not that bad. You know, I can't wait for the new pedal to come tomorrow. That's what I'm doing this. Like I said, if you're just joining, I'm using the micro pitch, delay pedal, Eventide, putting it into the chain here, see if I could get a more wider sound. And it did, it's a, you know, so let's look at the chat real quick. Oh my goodness. Thank y'all for joining. Wow. Mike is himself, S. McMillan, Bumbleus. He says it's like a stereo widener. Yes, that's correct. Lars Guitars, hey man, how are you? Bo Zeke, I had to refresh twice to see the chat. Uh-oh. Yeah, I don't know what's up with that, man. Sorry. Bo Zeke says, I'm at work, but watching this instead. Better than work, S. McMillan says. That's right. I hope I'm saying your name right. Ted Fair, hey man, I like my guitar tone like I like my women, big and wide. Hey, where's the, there it is. There you go, Ted. Yeah. That's awesome, man. Bumbleus, Joe, have you got any setting tips on your Zoom? I'm going to give it a shot. Yes, I made a video on my channel. It's a couple of years old. If you just go to my channel and type in Zoom G1X4, I show the settings on there. Absolutely. I haven't used it in a long time, but it's still a great little unit. I used Zoom G1X4 for quite a number of years, man. I always liked Zoom products. S. McMillan says, how are you running your chain, Joe? Out of the guitar, I'm going into a Zach wah pedal. And then next to that is the flanger. And then you got a tuner. And then you got the Phase 90. Then you got the EVH 5150 overdrive. And then the pedal board underneath this is what's going into the effects loop of the Headrush Prime. So, and then beside these boards, I got the Headrush Prime. And then after the Headrush, here's where a lot of people get lost, or they just don't recall. After the Headrush, I got the Boss SDE 3000 dual delay. Because you can run, you know, stereo in and stereo out. And then next to that is the micro pitch. And coming out of the micro pitch, outs one and two, I'm going into the Rodecaster right here. And I was getting some interference earlier, and I was like, why is this thing, what's that sound? And what it was the micro pitch and the Boss SDE delay were touching, and it was causing that interference. So I just happened to separate them, and it took it away. I was like, wow, that's crazy. But that's the chain, man, if that helps you. That is the chain. So, and I do have a Boss. I'm GE7 EQ in the effects loop as well. Kind of brightens it up a little. It's kind of muddy without it. What else can we do? Let's see here. Hey, Ted. It definitely sounds great, man. Are you getting the Eventide H9 pedal? I'm getting the Eventide pitchfork. That's coming tomorrow. But like I said, I just have this in the chain just to see if it will give me that widening effect. And it does. So I'm curious to see how the pitchfork pedal is going to sound when that comes tomorrow. Let's do some... do some funky stuff, man. You want to? Let's do a little funky stuff here. See how this will sound. Hey! Okay, man, so that wasn't bad. That was okay. Let's see, what's going on, man? Wow, y'all are so thankful. I'm so thankful for y'all. Thank you so much. Yes, Mr. or Mrs. or McMillan, the Eventide is running after everything. It's running last. Yes. That's correct, because it's a time-based effect, so you want it kind of last, you know, after everything else. Play that funky guitar. Hey, Randy Price, man. Randy Price. What's up, man? The Shred Master. I love watching Randy play, man. He's incredible, man. Huge respect to Randy, and a nice guy, too. I'd love to have him on the show. Bumbleus, I'm supposed to be showing these comments and I'm not. I'm sorry. Bumbleus in the chat. S. McMillan. And Lars Guitars. Hey, man. Nice to see you. Thank you very much. Sorry I wasn't showcasing these chats earlier. Poo Ninja, you had me at Eventide. What? That's pretty good, man. Ms. McMillan says, all work and no play makes Randy a dull boy. Yeah, Randy, stick around. You won't if you can. I mean, I know a lot of people that are at work. Uh-oh, there's the man, Ryan. There he is. My man, Ryan. What's going on? He says, I would try it with the Eventide before the delays. Okay. I can switch that around, absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah, man, like I said, I got a new pedal coming tomorrow. I just threw this in the chain just to see if it would kind of widen the sound. And it does, but I'm getting the Eventide pitchfork supposed to be coming from Sweetwater tomorrow. And it has all kind of widening and thickening audio effects and so I'm looking forward to that, you know. So anyway, yeah, man. So let's see if we can try another one. And see how it goes.
We'll be right back.
Oh man, a little VH. You gotta have some VH. Said VH, not V8. All right, what's going on? Oh, who's in here now? Man, let's see. Bumbleus, he says, Joe uses all kinds of different overdrives, EVH, Tube Screamer, etc. Yeah, I mean, I have in the past. I've mixed things up. I sure have, yeah. R23 said, I saw it even tied in the thumbnail. Yeah, it's in the title. I haven't had a chance to do a picture or nothing. This was just a quick thing. Just a quick kind of deal here. Yes. R2, you're correct. Is that the Rodecaster I see glowing back there? Yes. And all its glowing beauty. Yes. That's it. Absolutely. There's Andrew. What's up, man? Andrew, what is going on, my friend? He said, Ryan says, sure is, R2. Yeah. Andrew says, hey, Ryan. R2 says, woo. All right, man. Oh, man. That's funny. Oh, yeah. Cool deal, man. I'm so glad y'all are hanging around for a few minutes. Thank you so much. So, a big shout out to Ryan from OU812 channel. After the show Saturday night, him and Jimmy Biter both stuck around to help me kind of work my way through this a little bit. And, at least to get out of the gate, you know. And so I'd like to say, Brian, thank you. Jimmy Biter, thank you so much. Thank you for helping me. That was very kind. I really appreciate that so much. Do You Feel That, Man? Come on now.
I'd walk the war to you, babe. 1,000 miles with you. I'd dry your tears of pain 1,000,000 times for you. I'd sell my soul for you, babe. For money to burn for you.
Billy Idol. Come on now. The dog put. What's going on, my friend? How are you? He says, I have to add chorus in the mixing. Yeah, that would help too. With getting a wider sound, I would think, you know. Hey, R2 says, send Ryan $4.99 when the stream ends, Joe. That's right. PayPal or what's that other? Vimu or whatever. I'm going to sound like an old person. Whatever the kids use these days. Sounds like an old fart, don't it? Oh, my God. So I'm going to have to bring this one down a little bit here. Let's see what we got here.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. A little bit of Hendrix. Always love that song. Awesome, awesome song. Everybody having a good time here in the chat? Hey, Cushman, NYC, how are you, man? Cushman in the chat. What's going on, man? Nice to see you. Bumbleus says, whoops, let me go back up. Chat's moving. Thank y'all very much. Bumbleus with a question. Is that a stock pickup in the Strat? No, it is not. I got these pickups from Guitar Fetish. Yes. And put them all in here. I don't know if somebody else saw that. Yeah, Andrew saw that. I'm sorry. All right, let's see here. Yes. Guitar Fetish. Yeah, that's where I got these pickups, yeah. It's like a plug-and-play kind of deal because I can't solder anything worth a crap, so I got to do the old plug-and-play deal, so yeah. That's what I have to do, man. Oh, boy. That's old school. That is old school. Hey, Mr. Jeffrey Edwards in the chat. Hey, man. How are you doing? Jeffrey wants to know if I have any Foreigner. Oh my God. I do, but it's not that song. Man, I hope I can play it. I haven't played it in a long time. Let's see. Do I have it in here? Let's see. Okay. All right, Mr. Edwards, we'll try it for you. This right here. We'll try it, man. I don't know. Was for Mr. Edwards. All right. Yes. Thank you, Kush, man. Appreciate that, man. We can do maybe one more, and I gotta go. So this is the grand finale. All right, there we go, man. I hope y'all enjoyed that. And okay. If you're watching on the replay, thanks for watching, and give us a thumbs up or a comment or something if you can. That'd be great. Helps the channel. Any kind of interaction, man, really helps. So thank you to everybody who stuck this out. All right. I got to go. Thank y'all so much. I really appreciate it. Y'all have a wonderful and blessed day, and we'll catch you on the backside. All right. Bye-bye.